serious. Yes, I am serious. It's been a while I've spoke my heart out and didn't convey one important message about this channel which should be reaching people. Recently, I have been doing only the intro, outro, the content. So, hello, hi, welcome back to my channel content and like, share and subscribe. This is what I have been doing. This is not the only reason I have started up because there are n number of YouTubers who are doing this already so perfectly. So being so perfect is a must in this 2021, especially when you be little different from the rest of the people. You definitely can't expect the world to be very good, very kind, or they will definitely be mean, throw hatred, harsh comments as much as possible, right? So if you are in your teenagers who are going through some skin issues, either it may be acne or any skin issues, one thing I would tell you guys is just don't be hard on yourself. It will take some time. After some time, you will be completely free out of it. And one more thing is, if you are going through acne issues, please do not follow all those DIYs because acnes are literally very sensitive. And if you end up getting it, it's not because something which can be applied on the skin, external face, and it can be cured. It's not like that. When something is wrong within your body internally, that causes something on that can be the main reason for your acne to come up. Because for me, that was the case, and I was going through this hormonal issues. So if and for girls especially, if you are going through this hormonal issues or not having a good food routine, something is wrong within your body internally, you will end up getting this. So instead of following all those YouTubers, DIYs, I would tell please go consult a dermatologist. Why those people are there? As I said in my first video, I was a person who's being crossed facing all these things. And one thing which hit my mind is like, why is only all clear skin girls are coming forward and doing these things, and why not a girl like me coming forward and rotting in this thing especially? So that was a constant question running in my mind. Many international YouTubers have come forward and they are doing it, but in India it's very less because as I said, definitely people surrounded by you, definitely they won't make you feel good. They will try to pull you down. They will throw harsh hatred comments as much as possible. So when you keep hearing all those things, you will definitely not be confident about yourself, because I was not confident about myself. At one point of time, something will make you understand that, okay, this is what it is. This is what I am. I should accept myself. At the same time, people who are going through this should also feel happy and good about it. And you will, when you get this thought, you will definitely be very confident and you will try to motivate others to who are going through these issues. So that is what I wanted to do. So like, if you are going through this acne issues and you are expecting this kind of a videos, like if you have thought that there is nobody to represent you all, I am there. This channel is definitely there. So if you are a person, even if you don't have these issues, and if you if your friend or someone who is interested in makeup or have this kind of issues, please do share this channel as much as possible, because I want this particular channel to reach those people, because that is the main reason I have created this for. So if at one point of time, if it reaches you people, it might take some time. I definitely knew it is not just gonna happen in 1 month, 2 months. It might take some 8 months, 9 months, a year or 2 years. It's still fine. One point of time, if it reaches, please let me know in the comment section, because I will be happy. That will definitely make me happy. Okay, keeping all the serious issues aside, in today's video I have created a glamorous glam makeup look. To see how I created this one, without any further delays, let's get into the video. Thank you. this shade now, this green shade, and I'm again blending this out in the circular motion. Usually I used to make a slanting line pointing to the end of the eyebrow, but in this, for this eye makeup, I'm just placing right on the outer corner and I'm just blending this out in the circular motion. With the same brush, and I'm taking this purple shade and placing it on the outer corner of the eyelid as well, where I've applied the green shade, and even I'm just blending out in the circular motion. Green shade should also be visible in between the this purple shade should also be visible. So blend it in that way. And I'm just going to stop working on the outer corner of the eyelid, because this is how I wanted the it to look. So I'm just not going to do any further or add any other shades of fur. Starting from the inner corner till here of the eyelid, I'm going with this orange shade. Orange shimmery shade, which is there in this palette. I'm just working out with the help of my finger, and I'm just patting it on, starting from the inner corner till over here. On top of that, I'm going with this Maybelline liquid liner. Not sure whether I'm going to create a winged eyeliner, because I didn't decide it. Let's see. Okay, I'll be creating a small winged eyeliner. Really have a very shaky hand, so in order to just avoid messing up too much, so first I go with the kohl and then on top of that I go with the liquid liner. This is a very good trick, which if you people even have that kind of a shaky hands, or where you'll just mess it up, especially the eyeliner, you can definitely follow this step. Makeup is completely done, and I've applied some mascara and got the fake lashes too. So to start prepping the skin, so I'll be using the rose water as usual. This either you can just apply it with the help of a cotton pad or something, or you can just pour it on the palm and straightly apply it on your face. By this way, I'm just cleaning the under area as well. If there are, if there was any fallouts, it will be wiped out with the help of this. But once the rose water is dried, I'm going with the Cetaphil moisturizer. I'm taking a very less amount of product and applying it on my face. In my early videos, I mentioned I'll be using this Farsali serum in the all upcoming videos, but since I got some too acne, so I just stopped using this. I don't know whether this product caused acne or my food routine also got changed in the last 2 weeks. So I have to just wait for another 1-2 weeks and I have to analyze whether the food was the original reason for the acne or this product was the reason. If this is the reason, definitely I will not suggest to people to use this. If this is not the reason, then this is a very good product if you want your makeup to look flawless or glowy. To get that extra glowness and to make your pores to look very less, this will definitely is very helpful. For primer, I'm going with this Benefit one. I'm concentrating on the T-zone area. I will be explaining all the steps in all my videos, because if you're someone who have got to know about this channel for the very first time, so, and if I skip some steps, it will be very tough to follow or to understand. So I'll be explaining all the steps in all the videos. And I'm going with this MAC Stroke Cream in the shade Pink Light, because I thought of achieving a very glamorous, full glam makeup look today. And to get that extra glowness, I'm going with this Stroke Cream. I'm applying it on the cheek area. This can also be mixed with the foundation and applied on the face. And for color correcting, I'm going with this LA Girl Orange color corrector. I'm applying it around the mouth area and under the eye. Like wherever I feel that coverage is required or the pigmentation should be covered, I'm just working on that area. So it all depends on individual phases. And for foundation, I'm going with this MAC Studio Fix Liquid Foundation in the shade 44.5. As I say in all my videos, take extra time and blending, especially when you work on with the foundation, because when the foundation is not blended properly, that will definitely look very cakey after some time. It will just spoil your entire makeup look, because the foundation just acts as a base. When your base itself is not ready or not so perfect, your makeup won't look that great. So to achieve that glam look, I'm going with the Wet n Wild concealer in the shade a medium tawny. This is 2 shades lighter to my skin tone, since I wanted to highlight this area. So I'm going with the concealer which is 2 shades lighter to my skin tone. And one more trick, in order to stop the concealer creasing when you apply it over here, make sure you keep this area well hydrated. Either you can just apply some eye cream, use the moisturizer and make sure you apply it over here and massage it for few seconds, so that this place stays a bit hydrated. When this doesn't be hydrated, then there are high chances for your concealer to crease very soon. So now I'm taking a blender and blending this out. Make sure you don't disturb the eye makeup. To set the crease area, I'm using this loose powder from Maybelline in the shade medium. immediately when you work on with the concealer, make sure you just set it with a loose powder, so that even this helps from the even this stops from stops the concealer from creasing. Just apply a very less amount of product. Please do not follow this Insta makeup, because that seriously spoils the look. That definitely won't look on the day, won't look good in the daylight. So make sure you take the product upwards. That is, you blend the product upwards. I usually don't contour my forehead because I'm just not comfortable with that. I'm not doing it. And even on the nose as well. And now to set the jaw area, I'm again going with this Maybelline loose powder in the shade medium. Taking a good amount of product on the brush. I usually tell take a very less amount of product for either for the eyeshadow or just to set to under eye. But in this case, take a good amount of product and set the jawline area, so that this area will look clean and the contouring will also be well defined. The excess product definitely can be dusted out. Can be or should be dusted out. Now I'm going with this color bar blush in the shade Bronzing Glaze 11 Cheek Illusion Blush something. It's a toral based blush, toral tone based blush. Applying it on the apples of my cheek. I'll mention the lipstick shade in the description as the camera then capture the that part. So for the highlighter, I'm going with the same Maybelline one, and I'm just working on with the help of my finger, applying it wherever it's required. And finally, the full glam makeup look is completely done now. So to set this makeup look, I'm going with this MAC setting spray.